Welcome back. We are moving on to the last segment of this chapter, that's partial order and lattices. In this lecture, I'll be dealing with equivalence relation and how do we compare it with real life examples. Then we'll move on to the new type of relation called partial ordering and how do we represent them with Hasse diagrams. Here we have a set people. A, B, C, D, E. And there's a relation S which says sharing a room. A shares with B, B shares a room with C, and D shares a room with E. So what kind of relation is this? So let's try to analyze it. Let's test for a reflexive property. A shares room with A. When a person is in a room, he is actually sharing with himself. Yeah, this is acceptable. How about symmetric? A shares a room with B, it also means that B shares the same room with A. This is also acceptable. How about transitive? So A shares a room with B and B shares a room with C. With this, I could say A shares a room with C. This is also acceptable. So this is basically an equivalence relation. Let's represent this in the form of a picture. Let's say there are some rooms. With this data, let's fill these rooms. A sharing with B. So A and B are in one room. Then B sharing with C. That means C is also belong to this particular room. D sharing with E. And these two are not sharing with the other guys. So obviously they have to be in the other room. We already know that equivalence relation basically creates partition. And these are the equivalence classes. And what it signifies is all the elements belonging to a particular class hold the same property, or we can highlight the fact that equivalence relation can be thought as having equality or same property. Let me give you another example related to equivalence relation. Let's say you entered the college and the professor asked you, how did you come to college? And probably your answer is, I took bus 82 from home. Now think, is there only one particular bus with number 82? No, there could be many. Probably some 82M or 82L or 82K. There would be N number of buses which are moving in the route your home to college. Do you agree? Yep. Or maybe you want to travel to you from your home to a theater. Here you might pick up another bus, maybe some 36L or 36K or 36M, right? So if I think the set of buses, some 82M and 36L and so on, if this is the main set, probably we can define a relation route which is an equivalence relation on this set which partitions the set into subsets, where each becomes an equivalence class. What it signifies is, you can take any bus in this particular set to complete this task of coming from home to college. And we're not really worried whether you are taking M or L or K. We're only worried whether you are able to complete the task or not. Since each of these elements can equally perform this task, this forms an equivalence class for this particular relation root.
So equivalence relation highlights the concept of equality in elements of set. But do you think that every problem in this universe can be solved with equality? No, not always. A simple example
is taller an equivalence relation? Let's check. Think of symmetric property. A is taller than B. Does it imply B taller than A? No, it cannot be. If A is taller than B, then B must be short compared to A. Therefore, this does not hold. So taller cannot be classified as a equivalence relation. So there should be some other mechanism to handle these kind of things. Now this leads to a new concept called ordering, where a relation holds from A to B, but does not hold from B to A.
In this ordering, we talk about partial order and total order. So let's get started.
Partial order. A relation which satisfies reflexive, antisymmetric, and transitive. Reflexive is, for every element, there is a relation onto itself. Antisymmetric is, A has a relation to B, not equal to B relation A. Transitive, A relates to B and B relates to C, implies that A relates to C. Let's say the relation here is P, and we're going to use the symbol greater than or equal to represent the partial order. Now, why specifically this is? This less than basically highlights the fact that the relation can be only unidirectional. It's either A to B or B to A, but it cannot be on both sides. And this equality highlights that there is a reflexive relation A to A. Let's take an example to understand this. Here we have a set people A, B, and C, and the relation we are defining is not rich. A is not richer than B, and A is not richer than C. Does this relation P form a partial order? Let's check. First is reflexive. A not richer than itself. Is it right? Yeah. Then antisymmetric. A not richer than B. So it is obvious that the other way around is not possible. B has to be richer than A. So even antisymmetric is accepted. How about transitive? Let's say that A not richer than B and B is not richer than some D. So obviously A is definitely not richer than D. So even transitive property can be accepted on this. Therefore, this is actually a partial order. We can draw a graph for this partial order with these elements as the nodes. So we have A, then B and C. Because it follows a reflexive property, each will have a self-loop. Then the relation defined is A not richer than B. Then A is not richer than C. And it's obvious the other way around is not possible. There are two observations. Every node will have a self-loop and the graph will be unidirectional, right? So this diagram can be simplified. First thing is we will use dots for the nodes. So we have A, then B, then C. Because it's a partial order, it is understood that there will be a self-loop. So let's ignore that. Then because there's a relation from A to B, we take this particular element has higher order and this of lower order. So we put this down and this in the top. And we draw a line. And we do not put any arrow because we already know that the relation is from bottom to top. So therefore, relation should be A not richer than B. Similarly, A not richer than C. So I could put another line this way. Here we have taken the convention of relation being from bottom to top. And this way of representation is called Hasse diagram. Let's take an example to understand how to draw an Hasse diagram. Here we have a set P, 3, 6, 18, 24, and 72. And there's a partial order defined such that A is a factor of B. Let's try to draw the Hasse diagram for this. First, we pick up the first element, that is 3. So this will be the starting node. Now let's compare. So here the relation is factor. So is 3 a factor of 6? Yes, it is. So 6 has to be in the second level. And because the relation is there, we draw a line. Since the element 6 has satisfied the relation with 3, now we can make 6 as the base element for the further comparison. So let's take 6. Is 6 a factor of 18? Yes, it is. So 18 will be in the next level. Now the base element is 18. So when we compare with 24, so is 18 a factor of 24? No. So whenever the relation does not satisfy, we need to move one level back. So check with 6. Is 6 a factor of 24? Yes, it is. Therefore, we need to put this 24 above level 6. So I can put anywhere across. So I'll put it over here. 24. Now we have two elements as the base elements, so 18 and 24. So let's start with 18. Is 18 a factor of 72? Yes, it is. Therefore, I need to put it above this, 72. We also need to check with 24. So 24, is it a factor of 72? Yes, it is. That's how we draw the Hasse diagram. Here, there are a few things to note with the Hasse diagram. If you pick up any node, let's say I pick up this node, all the nodes which are at lower level and that are connected to this will satisfy the property, which means that 3 will be a factor of 72, 6 will be a factor of 72, even 18 will be a factor of 72. All these elements satisfy the condition factor. How about 18? Only the lower elements will satisfy. So 6 and 3 will satisfy. The element which is above and at the same level, these two do not satisfy, which means 24 is not a factor and even 72 is a not factor for 18. Let's draw Hasse diagram for this as well. Here we have a set P, 2, 4, 6, 8, and the partial order defined is A less than B. So let's start with the first node, that is 2. Compare it with the next element. Is 2 less than 4? Yes, it is. Now this is the base element. Compare it with the next element. Is 4 less than 6? Yes. How about 6 with 8? Yes, 6 is less than 8. So this is the Hasse diagram for this partial order. Do you see anything unique in this? Yes. Here each of the nodes are connected in a sequence and there are no branches. This type of connection is called as chain. There is one specialty for this. You see that every two elements can be compared. So if I take 2 and 4, 2 is less than 4. If I take 4 and 8, 4 is less than 8. Or if I take 4 and 6, 4 is less than 6. Any two elements can be compared. In a partial order, if every two elements can be compared, then that order is called as total order. If you look into the last example, this is not a total order because 18 and 24 are not comparable. Here's a question asked in gate 1996. Let x 2, 3, 6, 12, 24, 36 and the relation less than or equal to b such that x less than y. If x divides y, draw the Hasse diagram of this partial order. Let's pick up the first node. That's 2. Then compare it. Does 2 divide 3? No, it does not. Therefore, put the 3 also in the same level, at the lowest level. So now we have two base elements. So let's check with the first element. Can 2 divide 6? Yes, it can. How about 3? 3 also can divide 6. Therefore, I need to put the element above this. So let me put it somewhere in between. 2 can divide 6 and even 3 can divide 6. Now this will be the base element. So can 6 divide 12? Yes. Then 12, can it divide 24? Yes. 24, can it divide 36? No, it cannot. So we move one step back. Check with 12. 12, can it divide 36? Yes. Therefore, we need to put above 12. So I'll put somewhere over here. 36. So this becomes the Hasse diagram for this partial order.